Hello and welcome to another edition of Community Forum. My name is Joseph Feaster. I'm the host of the program. And as you know, if you watched the program before, I always have a series of exciting guests, and this program is no different. Today I'm talking about an institution that has really worldwide acclaim for the work that it does, working with all generations of people, from children to seniors. And here in Stoughton, we're fortunate to have such an organization, this organization here as well. And I'm referring to the Stoughton YMCA, or for some of you may know it as Old Colony YMCA. And I have with me today, my guests today are not only the vice president for Old Colony, but board members and their director of annual giving. So why don't we get underway so that you can meet all of them and we can begin our conversation. So I want to welcome you all to Community Forum.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here today. I made sure that I put the vice president next to me. My good friend Ellen Green is the vice president of Old Colony YMCA. Next to her is a dear and longtime friend with a deacon at the church which we attend, a Morning Star Baptist Church in Mattapan. But in this role today, he is a board member of the YMCA, Old Colony YMCA. Next to him is Danielle Justo. She is a board member, a distinguished member of the bar, and that's the bar meaning lawyer here, and is also a board member of the YMCA. And next to Danielle is Lauren Scott, who is the director of annual giving for Old Colony. So, you know, I wanted to have it because we're going to be talking about a number of things, and each of you are going to get an opportunity to speak of it from your perspective. I'd always like to have it start by people getting to know you as the persons that you are. So you can give your brief bios on, so people will get a sense of who you are. So I'm going to start with you, Madam Vice President.
Thank you. Well, first of all, thank you very much for having us here. We love the show, and we are invited on the show several times, but this particular show is very important to me, mostly because Joseph is involved in some of the work that we do. So I do want to share that. My role at the Y is really manifold, but most of my responsibility is all about making an environment that is engaging to all and is inclusive to all, in all diverse populations, anybody who needs to be part of a community. It's about strengthening families. I could go on, and I probably will do a little bit more than that. But really, you wanted to ask me about my bio. And I started at the JCC, which was the same building as the Y, in 2006, and as a membership director in that role. And I've been promoted several times, and I have my experience with the Y is now 10 years.
Oh, wow.
So 10 years with the Y, and I do oversee all of Stoughton, the Stoughton Y, as well as membership for all 7 branches that we have at Old Colony Y.
Jeff Perry?
Yes, my name is Jeff Perry, and I'm a real estate broker, also a management consultant. Got involved with the Y, actually when it was the JCC, I've been a member ever since, and I remember the transition from the JCC to the Y. And like many people, I would attend the Y, go in, do my workout, and leave. And a friend of mine mentioned the possibility or asked if I would be interested in possibly being on the board. And it was funny because I would see Ellen all the time, and we really didn't know each other. And we sat down, and I just jumped at the opportunity to see how I could help and share some of my gifts and skills to help better the organization.
Danielle.
I'm Danielle Justo. I'm an attorney with Rich May in Boston. I've been practicing for 17 years now, and I was just made chairman of the real estate department, by the way.
All right. Congratulations.
Thank you. And I've always wanted to give back to the community, so I've done pro bono work, and when the opportunity for a board membership came up, I thought this would be a great way to get involved with our community here in Stoughton.
And Lauren. Last but not least.
Yes, yes, thank you for having me. So I'm a YMCA employee. I've been working for RY for 21 years. I started when I was 10, actually 16. But I grew up at the Y. I was a camper. I was a lifeguard, a counselor. And I kind of just, once I started as a teenager, I had the opportunity to work in many different facets of the Y. Our Y is really special. I did a lot of social service work, so I worked in that segment for a long time. But for the last 4.5 years, I've been the director of annual giving, which I love because I love talking about the impact of what our organization does and how it reaches so many different families and kids. And I'm also a parent of Y kids, so my kids are in child care. My son's part of our Y Ability Special Needs Program. And I love the work that we do, and so I don't even look at it as a job. I really look at it as an opportunity for impact and support and just build a relationship, so.
Well, it's fascinating as well, because I'm a Y kid, but I was in a different place. I'm a New Yorker, as I always tell folks, born in the Bronx, raised in Queens, worked in Brooklyn, partied in Manhattan. But I went to the Flushing YMCA, and I hearken back to a time frame when we used to watch Flash Gordon on the Super 8 and would do that. I learned my judo. I learned my swimming. I learned basketball. I learned, back then we could play dodgeball the real way. and all of the things, but it was a matter every Saturday, my friends and I, we would trek off, take the Q48 into Flushing, across from Flushing High School, and go to the Y. In fact, I was home recently and went up Northern Boulevard just to see it's still there, still providing in the community. So when we start talking about the Y, I want to say to people, the Y is an institution. It is a community gift. It's a community partner that does a lot in whatever community they exist in. I was, 9 years old when I started going to the Y. So Ellen, I want to come to you because I'd like to have folks get a sense of what are the offerings at the Stoughton Y. Jeff, I'm going to go to you and to Danielle and turn to talk about, you mentioned coming on the board and why, but you also have our members, your users, and you want to encourage, and you're also going to be involved with a program that we'll talk more about on May 9th. And then Lauren, I'm going to come to you. I want the heavy hit as to why it's a good thing for one to give. Mm-hmm. And with that conversation, I'm sure that we'll be able to take up all of the time for the program today, and I definitely want us to do that. So my good friend Ellen, please tell us about what the Stoughton Y offers, and you can go as wide and as deep as you wish to.
All right, great. So I'm going to start by just sharing our overall, like when you walk in the door, what it might look like, because I think oftentimes people have an expectation of a gym and a swim, right? And right behind you, you can see behind my picture is a picture of the Y. It's a beautiful building. But it's not what the building is, and it's not what it has in terms of facilities. It's really about what it's providing to families and community. Mm-hmm. So let's talk a little bit about that. So yes, there's weights, and yes, there's cardio equipment, and yes, there's opportunities for great workout classes, which I happen to like, because personally, my big thing is, it's great to work out and go to a place and just work out, but really what it's great is getting to know other people and socializing and sort of saying hello. And so our classes really provide that opportunity. And it's all part of our membership. So it's not like these extra fees going out in there and whatever. And then, of course, we have things like people learn how to swim at the Y, right? Mm-hmm. People, and it's not just, let's say, learn how to swim, but let's say we could talk about a WaterWise program that we did this year, which is, we did it because we generated funds through Lauren's ability to raise funds. To actually provide second graders with an opportunity, and specifically we did it in Avon Schools, to come to our building and take lessons for 7 weeks. And these lessons weren't lessons like, let's make the stroke perfect. It's about, let's be safe in the water.
Yes.
Right? It's not about, yes, I want people to get swim team, and I want them to grow in their skill sets, right? But what we really want is we want the community to be safe. So these kinds of programs allow that safety, and what's more important, what the teachers and the parents told us is that these kids build confidence. So it transfers into the educational day. So
well, let's talk about, I mean, yes, you've focused on the on the young folks. I mean, like I said, I started at 9 years old in the Y. But the Y is much more than that, and it's intergenerational in a lot of different ways. Let's talk about, you know, how now that I'm no longer nine, you know, I have a couple of nines, multipliers. Let's talk about some of the other programs. You have programs with veterans.
We have programs with seniors.
You have physical therapy that takes place there. You got restaurants there. Let's give them the whole thing.
I think he could do that. I think I got sidetracked because I really thought that particular program. But anything in the pool, so there's group fitness classes in the pool, which are mostly catered to the adult population, and that's because it's easier on your joints, right? So there's programs like that. There's a, let's say there's a gardening program, this we're coming up in the next week, where we're actually having somebody who does gardening have a class, and it's free. It's just like, let's get the population together. But let's talk about the other things. So yes, we have everything from childcare. So in our building alone, we have 187 children a day in childcare, because in our world today, families need childcare. So that's one thing. And then after school, we have 110 kids every day in our after school program. So that means on a school vacation week, they're all there today, because parents still need the care. Mm-hmm. So there's things like that. There's an opportunity, there's a restaurant. It sounds so funny, but it's all about that community feeling, so that you come in, and yes, we have veterans programs, and we have camp. Our camp has over 400 kids in it every single day, and it's out throughout the summer, and it caters to everybody. So we provide, if you're in a voucher, you have a support, you have a slot. If you need a little bit of scholarship, a little bit of assistance, that's what the Y is there for. That's why we are always raising funds, so we can do these things for families who may not have the same ability as other families. But at the camp, there's archery and a pool, an outdoor pool, and there's a ropes course, and there's drama, and there's art, you know, arts and crafts, and not arts and crafts like drawing, but arts and crafts like fun things that you do.
In fact, I think I tried climbing the rope.
I think you did.
The rope ladder.
And you know, it's on 54 acres. And, you know, I don't think people have any kind of sort of vast knowledge of the facility. So 54 acres of the camp, and then you think about 108,000 square feet in the building. So there's a play space for families just to come and enjoy and take part in it, bring their children or grandparents, because, you know, we have blended society today. Mm-hmm. So it's not just parents taking care of children, it's grandparents taking care of children.
And in fact, folks come from the senior center on particular days as
well. Wednesdays,
that's right, on Wednesdays. I pay attention when I'm around there.
Yeah.
But if I let you go on, you're gonna dominate the entire program, and I can't let that happen. So I'm gonna go to my board members here. Jeff, I'd like you to talk about, you said you were there from the predecessor to the Stoughton YMCA in terms of JCC, mm-hmm. and you continue with the Y and further got more involvement by becoming a member of the board. Let's talk about how that experience has taken you to where you are now as far as being on the board and even talking about the program that's upcoming on May 9th.
Okay. Well, for me, my association with what is now the Y happened as a result of JCC. My son wanted to play basketball. It was snowing cold, and it was maybe during one of his breaks. And like most parents, I want my son to be happy. We went over to and signed up for the JCC, and when it transitioned to the Y, it was such a great place. We stayed. Wasn't too sure what that transition was gonna look like because, you know, it was something different. But nevertheless, it was such a part of our family and what we do that I decided to, we stayed, and we've been very, very pleased. So my son was 10 years old or so, now he's 26. He's still a member of the Y. My daughter is in college, and when she comes home, she comes and attends the Y. My wife is involved with the various activities and training at the Y as well. So for us, it was great because I could come to the Y and go downstairs and do a spinning class. My son could lift weights or play basketball. My daughter could do one of the cardio classes if she liked. It just works for us. And I think one of the most important pieces is, like Ellen said, you know, all of those things are a part of the membership fee. So I've been a part of other institutions where, you know, it's extra $10 here and, you know, $20 there, and those things add up. Another thing that that I love about the Y is just, again, the people. The people who work there are committed and always friendly. The people who we train with are courteous and they're various ages. So, and from different cultures and different countries. And it's actually a very, very incredible place. And in this culture that we live in where there's the needs of people are so great, it's good to be able to meet people from different places, to just be a part of an organization that is accepting and sensitive to those people. The other piece for me in terms of becoming a board member is because I have such a personal understanding of the things that the Y does, and obviously being a member of the board now, I've learned even so much more about all of the great things that they do. I have diabetes, and they have a pre-diabetes program. We've all had individuals who've, you know, suffered from various types of cancer. They have support for individuals with cancer. There's my dad worked in social services, worked for DYS, also ran a residential home. They have services where they're providing the Y. I didn't know this. Most people with the gym and swim attitude don't know that the Y has programs in which they're benefiting people in these real serious situations where they have some very specific needs, mental health services. Mm-hmm. So I was just amazed, and because of my background with doing some things, Joe Feaster and I have done some things with our church, and we've had the dubious distinction of having to meet people in some very difficult situations. So we understand the need for people to give. We understand the need for to be able to provide the services that, you know, we really believe people deserve. And this is just an extension for me of being able to do that.
Wow. Well, you know,
perfect.
Well, I can just say, Danielle, I know as well, just by the meetings that I've attended where you've been participating in around this event for May 9th, I got an understanding of your intimate relationships and involvement at the Y as well,
yes,
from the use of the facilities for the things which you, I believe, dance is
one
of them.
Yes.
I just want to show you. I just want to let you know. I'm paying attention when I'm in meetings. But as well, you decided to become a board member. So
Yes. Let's
talk about your movement into from a member Yes. To a user of the facility to now a member of the board.
I have to say, I did not know that you were from the Bronx because my family had a deli on Carpenter Avenue.
So
my village, per se, is in New York and Connecticut.
Okay.
So when I moved up here to go to law school, and I have my village back there. When everyone says it takes a village to raise children, it really does. And this is, the Y is really our community village. So we moved to Stoughton 6 years ago and not knowing anyone. So it was, you know, my second maternity leave, which I had a little three-year-old toddler running around with an abundance of energy and a newborn and a cold November, to your point. And the play space was just a wonderful asset to have, and to have the kids be safe and run around and me just kind of hold my newborn and have everyone just welcome me into the door and hold the door open. I had, you know, diapers. I just looked like a dysfunctional mom, like dropping diapers and bottles and carriages and everything, you know, and they're just like, come right in, and held the door open, and everyone was just you know, I have friends from that time period, and just my little guy would just be worn out, and then we'd head home. And so then they started getting really involved in the different programs. So I asked my 8-year-old son this morning, what was his favorite thing about the Y? And he said the Ninja Warrior class, where they swing from ropes and jump over, you know, all of it's very safe, the platforms and things like that. And because he still has an abundance of energy. And I asked my five-year-old, thinking she was going to talk about the wonderful Mommy and Me tap dance, right. Which there's a daddy now, so we have daddy and mommy and me in the program and our tap dancing skills. And she actually surprised me and said it was Peppercorn's Cafe.
She liked the food.
But that's after her mom. Loving the food. Food comes first. So it's really been just this wonderful network of families that we have met and friends that they have made from the various programs and, you know, learning to swim. They both learned to swim at the Y and all of the different activities, t-ball, camp, everything. They're, you know, and I do want to mention, though we're not seniors yet, that there's that incredible pickleball program that gets extremely competitive. And it keeps a lot of, you know, some seniors, but other folks too, very active indoors at the Y too.
So what made you go from a user, where in terms of providing the services that you needed as a new mom and having a newborn and also having a rambunctious and energetic 3-year-old, and then finding your interest as well there, but what made you decide to become a board member?
I was just finding myself just touting the wonderful assets and that the Y had, and you know, being a resource for different folks, asking me questions about the programs, and we signed a couple people up last weekend, other families that the kids are in the school together, and I just said this is my chance to help guide and work on and, you know, give back to the community and work on a board that is just a phenomenal board.
Well, Lauren, I've gotten to you, and I always, you know, as I said off air, was, you know, always focus on the dollars because the services that have been talked about, both from a vice president's perspective and also from a board member perspective, it takes money in order to offer these programs, to give these scholarships and vouchers and provide the types of services at a to have a membership that for an individual I can say is somewhere in the 40s and maybe for a family somewhere in the 60s or 70s. I mean, that takes, you know, and to keep a facility afloat requires another level of giving from individuals who have the capacity to do so as well as corporations. Let's talk about it. You're the director of annual giving. I can see the smile on your face. You like talking about the money aspects of it, so you're on.
Absolutely. Well, thank you. So what I think what's special about our Y is that it means something different to different people. And so I think because of that, people get connected in different ways. Like you said, Joe, growing up, it was really a piece for you in terms of connection to your community. You went and played basketball. It was a place to go stay safe. For you, Danielle, it got you back from maternity leave, which absolutely, as a mother with young kids, it's that connection piece. And I think closeness for you and your family, Jeff. And I think that's what the Y is. For every single person, they have a connection. And I think what makes our Y special is that in order to be able to make the Y available to everyone, we raise funds every single year. And like Ellen says, we do raise every single day. We're looking to find new ways to make new opportunities for connections. We're very blessed that we've got a lot of support from the community. But in order to make sure the Y is available to all, we raise funds throughout the year in different ways. We do different fundraisers. We do different personal asks. But in order to do that, we want to be able to make sure that the Y is available to everyone. Last year, we scholarshiped at camp. We had about probably 1,600 kids that attended camp throughout the entire summer, and 56% of them were able to go because of financial support. And I will tell you that every dollar that we raise, we're able to actually use that to maximize and goes back into the community. So as an association, for the entire Old Colony Y Association last year, we raised over $2 million, which was absolutely amazing, and it was a historic number for us as an association. But what we were able to do with that, more importantly, was not only put all of that back into the community and into our programs, but we were able to use to subsidize with other state and federal dollars. We were able to actually give out over $7 million in support.
Wow.
And that's in terms of memberships, that's camperships, that's different programs to support. And so we just want to make sure that we never have to say no to anyone.
and we are constantly looking for new ways to raise funds. We're looking for new programs to support the community. So we talked a lot about Live Strong and child care and different things, veterans programs, which is so important, especially in this community. But something that's really near and dear to my heart is our special needs programming, which we unveiled about 3 years ago, and now it's an association-wide program called Y-Ability. And it really is making sure that the Y is available to all. So in Stoughton specifically, we have about 5 different programs for all different ages, from swim programs to arts and crafts programs to health and wellness programs, in terms of we have, Taibo, but jujitsu for kids with special needs. So, and I think what we've done with that is tried to be as inclusive as possible and really making the Y accessible for all. And we say that because when you have a special needs child or individual, the Y can be a very overwhelming environment. But our Y has really tried to work with the families. We've worked with parents that have kids on the spectrum or that have different disabilities to be able to find a way to make sure the Y is available, to make sure we can have access to the programs appropriately for them in terms of sensory issues, in terms of just really meeting every child where they're at. And so I think that whenever there's a community need, the Y is really great at trying to work with people to make sure it's accessible to them, whether it's how they physically get in or whether it's how they financially can be supported to come into their programs.
I'm going to let you go.
I was cheering you up, Ellen, wasn't I?
I can feel the energy. So go ahead. I'm not even going to do an intro
I'm
to
so
you.
Sorry.
Go ahead. No.
I just wanted to say, just because I was, as she was talking about sensory and how we're focusing on what we're doing, we're having an event on April 27th, which is called Healthy Kids Day. This is not related to why we're here today, but I think it speaks to what our goals are. Our goals are to keep families, strengthen our families. And one of the things we're doing is a sensory hour for the first hour for kids with special needs.
That's amazing.
Because that's, so we extend our day.
What time on the 27th?
It's 9:30. The sensory hour is 9:30 to 10:30, and the event is the rest of the event is 10:30 to 1. So it goes 9:30 to 1. And the concept is just that the kids who have more sensory issues, noise issues, whatever those issues are, will be more comfortable mm-hmm. in that first hour because it's not full force. Yes.
That's a Saturday.
It's a Saturday.
Saturday, April
27th.
So let's give it again. Saturday, April 27th.
Healthy Kids Day.
And the time?
The time, again, is 9:30, 10:30 for sensory hour, and then 10:30 to 1 for the rest. And it's community. So I don't know exactly all the vendors who are going to be there, but I wouldn't be shocked if it's the library, Stop and Shop. Stop and Shop, maybe not so. Sorry. But there are lots
of... Well, maybe
of
they will be.
there are vendors that will come in and actually are supporting our community.
Does one need to be a member to come?
Not at all. And it's welcome to all. I mean, the whole concept is make it a fun day. So we'll have some camp activities. We'll have all kinds of activities happening for the kids to take advantage of and for the families to enjoy.
But I also know that you have some videos about specific programs that you have. And so why don't you, so we can prompt Roy to bring those up at the right time. But I know you have some videos. Let's talk about those.
So let's talk about the Live Strong. Jeff brought that up first. So mm-hmm. let's talk about Live Strong a little bit. So Live Strong is a program that we provide. It's an ongoing program. It lasts for about 3 months each time. So we have about 4 sets that go on every single year.
And we have a video for that?
We do.
Roy, if you can bring up the video on that would be great. Thank you, sir. You can continue to talk.
So I think what's most important about this video is sort of, I guess, it actually has, well, whatever, that's fine. So these are people who are talking about, and we'll make sure we have that available to you, but these are people who are talking about their experience with the Live Strong program. So they're saying that it's a wonderful program. So this is a woman, Michelle, who's talking, and she has cancer, and she didn't know how to deal with it, right? So Live Strong is a program that's designed to help support people who are experiencing cancer or who have experienced cancer, and they're trying to figure out their next steps in life. And people, if you have had it, then you probably understand. If you haven't, you might not. And I think part of it is that these people, they used to be very active people in society, and they sort of, life had to change. And now they're trying to figure out how do they get back into it, and they need people who are related to them. Does that make sense? That are connected to them.
because I think
folks who have been in their space,
exactly, you know,
have, walked
understand,
their, have walked their walk,
walk yeah. their walk, because yeah. people who don't necessarily walk their walk. So this is a particular program that I think is very near and dear to me, mostly because I meet all of them. There's usually somewhere between about 15 participants per class, and it's doctors suggest that they come to the class, and they're given training. It's a physical physical and emotional training program.
And I'm just going to hop in because I'm also aware of that Jeff mentioned about the diabetes. I know you have a diabetes program. I know there's also a program that focuses on persons who are recovering from cancer. Along that whole spectrum of activities which deal with people and their health challenges, the Y provides that type of thing.
I was going to say that healthy living, we have actually a healthy living department, and mm-hmm. that's, so we do healthy weight in a child. So you have a child who has some issues with their weight, we have a great program for that. We have senior programs that are specifically designed for, it's called Forever Fit, and it's really about how do we keep our fitness going. We provide statistics on this information, so we understand what role we've played in all of this. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I almost started to take that class, but I'm not there yet. I'm not, I'm not there. I can't take Danielle's dance class.
But, oh, yes, you can.
Yeah, but in turn, well, I can dance though. But
there's also like a high blood pressure program, yes. And you know that affects so many of us. So there's so many healthy living, and I put that in quote it, type programs, and it's really about what are your needs. Where do you, what, how do you, how can we support you?
Well, what I'm going to do, because I'm going to, I don't want us to miss one of the major reasons why we're here. What's this example of the conversations that we've all had, because I'm a member at Stoughton Y as well, is Stoughton Y is a good neighbor, and has now been here 10 years. And you're about to celebrate a 10-year celebration coming up on May 9th. And so while Roy brings up that cue of the invitation on that, why don't we talk about the program? I want all of you to chime in on that piece. So starting with you, Ellen, talking about why the event, and the excitement around that, and who can attend, and all of that.
So the event is designed for twofold. One is to engage our members and our current donors in all the work we're doing. So people know things piecemeal. So they might know about our Live Strong program, but not about our pre-diabetes program. So how do we really want to make it an informational session and give people the opportunity who are currently engaged with us to donate to us, to continue to donate, or to people to be the first-time donors. On the second session, which is 7 to 8 p.m., it's really invite the community to say, hey, come learn more about us. Because if you're not in our doors every day, you really aren't. You don't know what we're doing. So we want that second session is really, let's get all community members who are not necessarily connected directly to the Y, in a sense, but they can, people can bring other people to it, or whoever in the community would like to engage more or learn more. It's really a learning. And we're learning about the impact. It's all about impact.
Well, that is for sure, but we have two great co-chairs for that event, our board members, both Jeff and Danielle. Let's talk about it. Let's rev it up. Let's tell folks why they need to be there on May 9th. If they want to come at 5:30 to members and stay all the way to 8, we'll love to have them. But in terms of fine, let's talk about the why for that event.
You go first. Well, I think it's important for people to come, particularly members. I know there's always an attempt to attract outside corporations, but I think there's a vast untapped group of people who are members who, like myself, was not aware of all of the things that the organization does. And I think once you find out some of the good work that the organization is doing, I don't see how you can't want to be a part of that. And to maybe contribute to that. So I speak to people and I do my little indirect poll, on the gym floor. And when I ask people about their knowledge of some of the things that go on at the Y, a lot of them don't have a clue, because they come in, they get their workout in, they swim, they go to their class, and they leave. So I think it's very important for people to come by, find out what it is we're doing, and then contribute and be a part of that. Also, I think that if you know, and it, for most of us, I too am a Bronx kid. I actually lived in the Bronx from
probably right.
I was born in Harlem, lived in the Bronx till I was about 8 or 9 years old, and came to Boston.
We should all wear our Yankee shirts. Yeah.
I've kind of been removed for a bit, but I do fight with my relatives in New York all the times about all of our success lately here in Boston. But anyway, but I was born in the Bronx, and I lived in Roxbury, Mattapan, and for me, you know, we talked about the Y. Now, in Roxbury, when I was growing up, we had the Roxbury Y. Roxbury Y was further away from me. I basically went to the Shelburne Center, so anyone from Boston will know Shelburne Center. And it was just because it was in proximity to my house. But a good friend of mine, her father, Jack Cooper, ran the Y for
That's
years.
Right. Right.
And so we did do events. I went to Boston Technical High School, which was
right near
at the Y. So I have visited and been a part of it. My point is, at the Shelburne, whether it was the Shelburne, whether it was a Y, whether it was a Boys and Girls Club, you know, most people who grew up in the city understand that that there were a lot of us and a lot of parents, and I was a little more fortunate than a lot of my friends, but a lot of my friends, like you said, didn't have the means to pay for some of the memberships. Could it go on some of the trips if there weren't people donating money or sponsoring them? So I think sponsorship, giving back, paying it forward is just vital. And to whom much is given, much is required. So I think for those who have the means,
spoken like a true deacon,
I think you have an obligation. Only the things we do for God shall last. So I just think there are just things that we can invest in, support, be a part of, and be a part of the solution as opposed to mm-hmm. complaining about the things that are not right.
And before I go to you, Daniel, I want to be able to say to the viewing audience, this is not a fundraiser that we're having on May 9th, and Lauren's giving me the evil eye, but that's okay. But I want to emphasize that what it is, that's the piece we want to introduce folks. We want to have opportunity to have a conversation with the members, mm-hmm. get them more engaged and more involved, and if that results in their giving, I'm not going to say we're not going to be asking, but that's not the major reason for the event. And when the persons come who are not connected to the Y presently, who we want to inform about the it's primarily informational, yeah. that too may result in their finding it in their hearts in order to participate in a financial way as well. But I want to say to folks, this is not a fundraiser. Mm-hmm. Come, hear the program. As members, we want to get you more involved, more engaged, more informed. For the persons who come at the 7 o'clock time frame, we'll give the specifics. We're talking about, we want you to learn what the Y is giving, because some of these services are things that you may need mm-hmm. and want, or know of persons who can utilize them. We want you to come learn more about this good neighbor that exists in our community and has existed for the past 10 years. So.
This is exactly what you just stole my thunder. This is exactly what I was going to say, was that several parents have asked me about, their membership has lapsed, or they used to be a member, or they were going to become a member. And this is a great opportunity, especially for the first hour that they've now become members, to learn about the programs. I've had so many parents ask me, oh, your son does this or your daughter does this. I didn't know we had that program right in our backyard. And so this is a great opportunity to learn about those programs. And like you said, this is not, you know, we have other programs to talk about where we have a lot of young people who become counselors in training at the camps. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of staff members who are young adults who have jobs and learn the ways of the real world by becoming employees of the Y. And there's a lot of people also who are volunteers. And I don't know if Ellen has any numbers of this, but there are so many of our staff members who actually volunteer at the Y, give back their time.
Well, what I was hearkening back as you were speaking, I am going to give you, Lauren, but probably after I go to my sponsors to come back and talk about some things. What I just thought about, We used to have a night where we slept over at the Y. I don't know if they still do that. We had that was just the greatest things. You'd be on the gym floor, didn't have a sleeping bag. It did. That didn't matter.
All-nighter.
You know, you may have had the mats or whatever the case, and they had hot chocolate and the movies. Like I said, we had Flash Gordon, and we would run the Super 8 thing back and forth, so you'd see the explosion as it was put back in, or the spaceship going back with. Those were the great times, and those relationships that you formed, not only with the persons who were the kids that were attending the program, but also with the persons who were giving you the instructions in the different things that you had, swing or whatever. But we're going to go to our sponsors for a moment, and when we come back, Lauren, I'm coming to you. Even though I said it's not a fundraiser, there's still a need to be emphasized the fact that the support is sorely needed in order to run these programs. Mm-hmm. We'll be right back.
Hi, this is Roy Cohen. The crew would like to thank Maxie's Delicatessen, located at 117 Sharon Street in Stoughton. You can reach them by calling 781-341-1662. The American Cancer Society is looking for volunteers to drive cancer patients to and from treatments. You can volunteer by calling 1-800-ACS-6662 or online at www.cancer.org. Ilse Mock's Food Pantry and St. Anthony's Free Market is located at 2 Park Avenue in Stoughton. For more information, call Christine Gallagher at 781-341-0611 or 781-341-0549. To get involved with Meals on Wheels, call Jessica at 781-344-8882, extension 2. The Stoughton Penny Saver, our business is advertising your business in Stoughton. To advertise, call 781-344-4833. Community Forum Showtimes here in Stoughton. You can see it on Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays at 6 p.m., Monday at 8 p.m., Tuesday at 5 p.m., either on Comcast Channel 9 or Verizon Channel 28. If you have any comments or suggestions, contact us at communityforum1@yahoo.com. Samaritans, 41 West Street, 4th floor in Boston, Massachusetts, 02111, or call them at 617-536-2460. The 24-hour helplines, 877-870-HOPE or 877-870-4673. Samaritans, 800-252-TEEN or 800-252-8336, or online www.samaritanshope.org. For you bingo players, I want to tell you about the Monday night bingo being held at the Ahava Torah Congregation, 1179 Central Street in Stoughton. The doors open at 4:30 p.m. The games start at 6:30 p.m. You come on down and win some money. They have two big prizes. One is $1,199 and the other one is up to $3,000. So come on down.
This is the celebration that we're talking about. It's coming up on Thursday, May 9th. We have an exclusive time from 5:30 to 6:30 for our Stoughton Y members. And then we invite the general public to come learn about the program, see what we're doing there, find things that you may make you a member. So we invite you to the earlier time next time we have the event. But this is 10 years, and as it says, we're celebrating 10 years of impact at the Stoughton Y. The Stoughton Y has been a good neighbor, and you've heard if you've been listening to the program, the many programs that the Y has. So again, Thursday, May 9th, 7 to 8 for the general public at the Stoughton Y, 5:30 to 6:30 for our members. Well, we are back, and as you can see, there's an array of persons who are sitting with me. I want to introduce them again. They're all from the Stoughton Y in some capacity. To my immediate right is the Vice President, Ellen Green. Next to her is a board member, Jeff Perry. Next to him is Danielle Justo, who is also a board member. And next to her, on the end, but not last but not least, is in terms of Lauren Scott, who is the Director of Annual Giving. And Lauren, I know that I said before we broke for a moment to have our sponsors be introduced. I talked about this isn't a fundraiser on May 9th, but I know fundraising is what you do. But I know you wanted to talk about, we talked about off air about the partnerships that the Y is engaged in. Can you elaborate on that?
Yes. We are very blessed to get so much support from the community in various different ways, and that's how we're able to do the work that we do and make the impact that we're able to make. We have partnerships with our local schools and the local towns. We work with a number of businesses that support our campaign or support our YMCA. Specifically, when I look at a most recent, very, very historic, successful event here in Stoughton, we had our spin-a-thon back on March 9th, yes. And we hit a historic, we raised over $100,000, yes. Which is amazing in one event. And it's a health event, it's a family event, but we got a lot of wonderful supporters through that. Harbor One is an amazing bank, and they have been fantastic in terms of really supporting us in our YMCA efforts and in that one event. Town Spa was amazing. If you had been there, who hasn't been there, the best pizza in the world. You know, they were raising a lot, raising money for us. We worked with NIS. There was FIS, who was amazing. They've been a longtime supporter of the work that we do. And then also our wonderful, our board chair's company is, what is his name?
Gene Inman's company.
Gene Inman's company. What's the name?
Yep.
It's a wonderful.
Well, we know
New England.
Gene.
New England.
Yep.
Okay. Well, that's right. We'll practice next time.
Yes, thank you. But we're able, you know, we're really, these companies and these community organizations, they work with us. We work with in terms of a lot of our different programs. Our program, in terms of our special needs programming, we've worked with CARD, the Center for Autism-Related Disorders. They've provided support for our programs and trainings for our staff. We've had farmers markets. Ellen, do you want to continue with some of the different?
Yeah, I think the concept here is I really want to share that not only we work with our town government, so like or their schools. So if there's a child in a school environment that needs support, they reach out to us. Really, it's about having this community. We talk a lot about surrounding services. All the services that we can provide, we work with whoever needs it. So it's all about that strengthening families. It goes back to that. So we have many collaborations, many partnerships that we work through in order to support the community as a whole. And I know, Lauren, you really are talking about financial, you know, raising money. But it's important for people to understand that if you have a need, you have to come to us. Mm-hmm. Because we're going to help support that need. And that's why we raise all this. That's why we try to raise all the money.
But also know that there is another video that you have. I'm not sure what it is, but if you can introduce it and then
I'm
we can ask
to.
Rory to bring it up, that would be great.
So, camp. So, you know, there are many experiences that we have throughout our life, and some of you have gone to camp and some of you probably have not. But I will tell you, in today's world, camping experience is so valuable for many reasons. One is that, I don't know how much you know about the summer slide, but the summer slide is really about you know, people, kids who lose, they lose 3 months of their summer, or their summer is 3 months long, and they lose their education from where they were in
June.
Well,
let me have Roy bring the slide up, and okay. So we can talk, so you can talk about it.
And I go to Camp Stoughton. My favorite part about camp is ropes and archery.
Hi, my name is Maria. I am 10 years old. My favorite thing about Y Camp is ropes, archery, swim, and course.
My name is Giovanni, and I like the Y Camp because of the pool, field, and my friends, and also the counselors.
At camp, I make lots of friends.
So much much for your support.
Because what it does is it shows the kids and having fun. And really, when we talk about all the things we do for the community, we want to support the whole community, children to adults to seniors to whatever, as 0 to 100 or 110, whatever it is. But really, our kids mean so much to us. And this is a great example of why we raise money, because every child should have an experience, a good camp experience, something that engages them over the summer, that builds their confidence and creates better adults, basically. So.
Let's talk about the camp for a minute, because my viewpoint is every child who lives in the city should have a camp experience. I strongly believe. I went to overnight camp. I went to a camp, again, I stayed in New York, upstate New York, area up in, was in the Shawangunk Mountains up by Port Jervis, New York. And I can tell you, I went there as a camper for 2 years. I went back as a counselor for 3 years, counselor in training, and then a junior counselor, and then a counselor for the oldest boys unit. Is the camp here, I know you have your day program, is there an overnight aspect to the camp? Let's focus in on the camp piece for a while.
The campus really runs from 9 to 4. Mm-hmm. It is, however, we have early care, AM care, so 7 AM drop off, and 6 PM when they get picked up. There is no overnight. Sometimes we have one special overnight. We do have family nights, so we do campfires and song singing and with families. We don't have an overnight camp. Our camp is really designed to engage our kids in activities that they might not normally know, like archery is a good example, or ropes. And also to engage them, you saw them with books. We really push that. We have a library. We call it the Y-brary at camp. But it's really about how do we connect that caterpillar that you saw to a book? Because I think when they realize that they are learning, it's all about that learning structure, and it has to be fun. So the camp is designed to make it available to everybody. It is a great fee, so that it's not sort of this overwhelming fee, and those who need scholarship get scholarship as well. And it's all based on Massachusetts. We do everything sort of based on sort of numbers, specific numbers, based on Massachusetts government and what they suggest. So I think it is a day program. It's 10 weeks. So you have care the whole time. And many of our children literally go from after school care to camp to after school care. So.
Well, as you know, with any great program, our time is starting to wind down. We're not there yet, but I want to give each of you, starting with Jeff, an opportunity to give your parting comment to our viewing audience about whatever aspect of this you'd like to share with them. So, Jeff, I'm going to give you an opportunity, then you, Danielle, and then you, Lauren. And then I want to thank some people who helped to make this program possible. So.
First of all, I'd like to thank you again, Joe, for the opportunity to be a part of the show. Secondly, I want to thank you for your contribution and expertise in helping us with the event that we're putting on May 9th. Joe and I have worked on a number of things over the years, and one thing I know is if he's going to be a part of it, it's going to be done correctly, and he's going to give his all. I also want to say I have always admired people who have a passion for what they do and who love what they do. And I think it's very, very clear when you talk to people like Ellen and you talk to people like Lauren, this is what they do. This is really who they are. So it's not hard work. It is hard work that, you know, the duties of the job, but you can see the passion and you can see why they do it and why they come back and do it every day. And it reminds me, again, a lot of my dad when he ran the various programs that he was a part of. Of which I went to a camp with this is a residence home, so these are some kind of rough kids, and I did camp with them. And it was an incredible experience. The other thing is, in terms of the whole idea that there's need, and for many of us who grew up in the city, we saw a lot of need. So I'm extremely sensitive to need, and I'm very sensitive to the fact that these things require resources. One of the great things that I know from being involved on the board of the Y is that the resources are used as they're supposed to be. A lot of people will use the reasons for not giving is because, well, I don't know if they're really doing the right thing. Well, they're doing the right thing. Mm-hmm. And if you come out to our event on the 9th, they can tell you and give you examples, and you can meet people whose lives are being changed and blessed and helped. And there are a lot of people at the Y, and it's an incredible place. It's an outlet. It's a place for, again, people to go hit a heavy bag or throw some weights around, where if they didn't have that release, they may be engaged in other things that wouldn't be as positive. So older people get to socialize with other older people. So depending on which time of day you come, you'll see an entirely different demographic of individuals. And I think that's fascinating. Mm-hmm. I've had, and it's my last piece, I've had a chance to shoot to do archery. I've had a chance to do Zumba. I've had a chance to do yoga. I've had a chance to swim. I've had a chance to play basketball. I have a chance to, you know, work out in this incredible new facility that used to be open air. And
well, Jeff, if
space.
I let you go on, no one else is going to be able to speak.
Hey, I'm
so I'm going to say,
thank you.
You're going to. Before I let you do that, I want to say my thank yous, and then I'm going to come back. I even let you run the time out. Yeah. But I have to say thank you to the folks which helped me put this program on, and particularly to Frank Walsh, who is the floor general here today and dealing with the cameras, and he has his own two programs here on Community Forum, and I recommend to you, the viewing audience, that you tune into his program. And that word is no play on words, because one of his programs has tunes in the title. Michael Hammond, who is the overseer of everything here in terms of the director or executive director of SMAC, Jeff Pickett, who is the program director. Leo McGowan, who was the floor person here, is recuperating. Leo, we want to say we're here. You're on the mend, and hopefully you will be back soon. We have Dave Young, who is he's the one I mentioned that's going to give us take whatever we do wrong here and put it in his video of bloopers, and CJ Mullen, who is also involved with the programming here. But of course, the persons who really make sure that I do this what I'm supposed to do as a host correctly are both my producers, Roy Cohen and Gina Coase. I want to say thank you to all of them. And I see that I didn't give, I didn't keep my word, because time is running out. So I'm going to say, I'm just going to say, this has been an extraordinary program. I want to thank each of you for being here. Ellen Green, Jeff Perry, Daniel Gesto, and also Lauren Scott. We're all part of the Y, folks. Roy, if you could bring up that May 9th flyer again before I close. I want to say thank you to you here, the viewing audience. We invite you to please join us at the Y on Thursday, May 9th. If you're not a member, come at 7 to 8. If you are a member, please come at 5:30 and join us. Again, my guest today, thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
This was wonderful.